Coming up on the next episode, the Mad Professor and Igor, the adventures of Letterman, and everyone's favorite superhero, Spider-Man.
Today on the Electric Company, we see the
It's never a dull moment here. Master, what is it?
It is ink.
Ink.
Yes.
Ink. Was it for, Master?
It's part of an important experiment I'm going to perform on you.
Master, will it make me a better person?
Better person?
Yes.
You're not even a person yet, Igor.
Thank you, Master. Oh, Master. Ink.
Yes.
Ink. I can hardly wait.
I think it's going to be very interesting.
Ink. Hey, you could hear your tongue saying ink. Ooh. I think I did.
Very good, Igor. Very good. You have successfully read part of a word.
Master.
Soon, Igor. Soon you will be able to read the whole word. Because today, I am going to make you think.
Think?
Yes.
Ooh, but how, Master?
Why, with my new invention, Igor. My new think tank. Get in, Igor.
Get in, Master?
Yes! Get into the think tank.
I can take a hint.
Yes, good. Now stand very still. Good, good. It appears I've invented a blink tank.
Stink. Skunk.
Master?
Yes, Igor.
Master, my eyes are tired from thinking.
Unfortunately, you are not thinking, Igor.
Ooh.
You are blinking. Mm. But don't worry. This time I'm certain it will work.
What, Master?
The think tank, you idiot.
Sweet talker.
Yes. In a moment, you will be able to think, Igor. Just think. Now, stand ready.
Okay.
Stand ready. Unless your eyes deceive me.
No.
This time I've invented a wink tank. But boy, we're getting closer. Now then.
Blink. Blink.
There now. That should give you something to think about.
What, mister?
The think tank. I gave it a tune-up. Down you go. There we are. Now just sit tight here. Igor! Igor, where are you?
Down here, master.
My heavens! Igor, I've made you shrink. Well, at least I've accomplished something.
What, master?
Well, thanks to my new shrink tank, your tiny little body is the same size as your tiny little brain.
You're a good master. Master?
Yes, Igor. Yes.
The Adventures of Letterman. Small talk. Today, we find our hero packing his trunk for a quick trip.
Now, let's see. I need my R and my V. Well, that takes care of all my letters.
Now I have that letterman where I want him. All his rotten letters locked in a trunk.
Oh, my.
And with that, our evil villain takes his magic wand and changes the TR into J, turning the trunk into junk.
Now, my meddling fool, I shall fix you for good.
The spellbinder takes his magic wand and changes the J into SHR, turning junk into shrunk. Oh, my goodness! Letterman has shrunk!
You were too big for your britches anyway.
Will our hero spend the rest of his life only 5 inches high? Will he only be able to use lowercase letters? Will he have to have his entire wardrobe altered? What can he do? Well, our hero may be small, but he still has power. Letterman flies up to the letters, faster than a rolling O, stronger than silent E, able to leap capital T in a single bound. It's a word. It's a plan. It's Letterman. He takes the SHR and flies away with it, leaving UNK, UNK.
UNK, UNK. What's that?
He flies back with H, making him the gorgeous hunk of Letterman that he was.
Ooh. Uh-oh.
Here I come.
Help! Why don't you pick on someone your own size?
Take that.
Oh, no! He bent my little... He bent my little wand!
Well, folks, it looks like the end of our villain. But is it? Tune in to the next amazing chapter and see.
Comes your friendly neighborhood web slinger. Today, Spidey meets the prankster. Spidey is visiting his friends at PS 8 and a half, where Mrs. Eckhart's music class is about to perform.
What's your request, Spidey? Oh, Jelly Belly. That's on page 49.
Good question, Spidey. Who is the prankster? Spidey decides to find out and follows his nose to Mr. Thurman's home ec class, where he smells something suspicious.
Oh, hi, Spider-Man. We just finished making a chocolate pie. Would you like a piece, Spidey? Chocolate?
Mud!
This is a mud pie!
Could it be the same prankster? Spidey's insect sense tells him that the prankster is about to strike again. This time in Mr. Ludkin's secretarial skills class, where a student is about to recite.
Now, class, I shall now demonstrate the proper way to answer a phone. First, you wait for the phone to ring.
Oh, very good.
Now, the ringing sound you hear is your signal to pick up the receiver. Hello? 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 Hello, can you hear me? Hello? Someone is trying to embarrass me.
Spidey decides to go to Mr. Prescott, the school principal, to warn him about the prankster. He doesn't find Mr. Prescott, but he does discover some very interesting things. A big bottle of glue, the missing chocolate pie filling, and a box of squigglies. Yes, true believers, shocking as it may seem. The principal is the prankster.
Where did I put that giraffe and the sneezing powder? Spider-Man! You... Please, you don't understand.
I don't believe it.
You don't understand. Children, I've been principal of PS 8 and a half for 13 years now, and every day you kids play a prank on me, and I just wanted you to see what it was like.
We understand, Mr. Prescott. We'll let you go this time.
Really?
Yes.
I just hope you've all learned your lesson and will promise never to play another prank.
We promise.
Okay, good. It's not nice to do that to all the people. Oh, thank you, Spider-Man. I'm sorry to tie up your day like this. I know you have bookkeeping and things like that. And you now just all behave yourselves and don't
forget
me.
And so this time, the principal has to stay after school. And things are back to normal at PS 8 and a half. It looks like Spidey stopped the prankster. But he didn't stop the pranks.
Spider-Man, where are you coming from, Spider-Man? Nobody
A daredevil named Frank jumped from a plank into a large tank with a loud clank.
Yuck! What a drink. It makes me blink. Do you know what I think? It's not water. It's ink.
And then, with a wink, took another drink and turned slightly pink and began to shrink. The more he drank, the more he shrank. So did the tank. And the screen went blank.
Oh, look, there's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Clown. Oh, before I say hello to him, I think there's something you should know. Rudolph doesn't talk with his mouth like you and I. He talks with his nose, okay? Hello, Rudolph. Hi. How are you? Oh, dear. Rudolph says, I am not well. Aw, what's the matter, Rudolph? Oh, you poor thing. Rudolph says, my nose is cold. Well, there certainly is a lot of it to be cold, Rudolph. But don't worry, I have a little present for you. Yeah, look over on the bench there. No? Yeah. It's a nose warmer. I knitted it myself. Rudolph says, you are very nice. Aw, I'm happy to do it, Rudolph. What? You look great, Rudolph. Yeah, just great. Bye-bye, Rudolph.
Close the door.
Hmm?
I said, close the door.
Did you say, close the door? Close the door.
I said, close the door.
Oh, he said, close the door.
Thanks.
Well, you're welcome.
Junkers. Junkers are 100% pure junk. Greg! Are you eating Junkers?
What, Mom?
I said, are you eating Junkers?
Yes, Mom.
It's pure junk.
What, Mom?
I said, it's pure junk. Come in here.
What, Mom?
I said, come in here. You have been eating junk all day. Now, why don't you eat a nice apple, nice ear of corn, piece of liver? Don't you want to be strong and brawny like your dad?
I'd rather be short and smart like me.
Thank you. That stuff, it's terrible for your health. And think of what it's doing to your teeth.
Oh, but Mom, look, it's got nuts. And nuts are supposed to be good for you, right?
Right.
Oh, Mom.
Quotation marks.
What?
I said quotation marks.
Oh, you said quotation marks.
That's what I said. That's why there are quotation marks around the words quotation marks.
Oh, now they're just quotation marks.
Greg has 5 seconds to read the next word he sees. Can you read it before he does?
Junk! I love junk!
Oi!
Oi! Oi! Oi!
B. Oil. Boil. K. Oil. Coil. K. Oin. Coin. J. Oin. Join. J. Oint. Joint. B. Oil. Boil. K. Oil. Coil. K. Oin. Coin. Oin, join. J, oint, joint. Yeah.
Where are they?
Hi, Mr. Breakstone.
No, no, my dear, not Mr. Breakstone. Breakstone, as in Breakstone the magician.
Okay, we heard you was looking for assistance.
Yes, we want to learn the magic business.
You're hired.
Well, you just like that?
Well, listen, I go on in 2 minutes, kids, right? So pay attention. Now look, right here is my famous hat trick.
Yeah.
Notice there is no bottom, and to the hat it's a fake-o. Also, there's a hole in the top of the table,
Mr. Right? Breakstone, that's cheating.
Look, kid, do you want to learn the tricks of the trade,
yes,
or what?
We do, yes.
Ten seconds, Mr. Breakstone.
Who said that?
Not Mr. Breakstone, just Breakstone, like that. But all right, now listen. What you're going to do, kid, you get under the table here.
We get under.
And any time I call for a prop, you hand it up to me.
Uh-huh. We would give it to you.
Right, okay, so let's get under there now.
Go on under, Priscilla. We're in show business.
We are proud to present, direct from a sensational one-day stand at PS 49, Breakstone the Magician.
Good afternoon, boys and girls, and teachers, what couldn't get out of it. Now, I would like you to observe closely my regular hat. You notice it has no fake top or artificial bottom or any junky stuff like that. And you must trust me that it is exactly like this hat, what is over here on the table. Now, today, boys and girls, and teachers, what couldn't get out of it, I'm going to take one fresh raw egg and drop it into the hat. Please observe. Yes. And we are going to turn that raw egg into a boiled egg. Indeed, you may gasp and wonder. Yes, it's going to become a boiled egg. Here we go.
Oh, hey, Howard, look, what? He wants us to hand him
something.
What
does something. He
want? I don't know.
Maybe it's this.
Oh, what is
it? It says coin.
Oh, that must be it. You know,
gotta be.
Magicians always do it.
Give him one.
Okay. Mr. Brightstone.
Well, no boil egg that time, boys and girls. Wanted to see if you was paying attention. This time we have a coin, which you can have just that. Aha! And now, fortunately, we have a second raw egg that we can change into a boiled egg. Please observe.
Oh, what did he say?
I heard, I think he wants something else. I heard an oi.
I guess we have to wait a moment while the water's boiling in order to get our boiled egg.
Oi.
Wait a minute. Oh, this must be it. Look.
Is that it?
Yeah. Oil.
Okay. I'll give it to him.
No, let me.
I want it.
No,
I want it.
You shoving it.
Ha, 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 these are the jokes. Yes, indeed. Well, I guess we'll have to just see. Now, fortunately, we have a third and final raw egg to give us one more chance to get a boiled egg. Please observe. Abracadabra and raka raka.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
Hey, wait a minute. Hey, that was going to be my lunch.
Oh, you meanie.
And through the magic of magic, we have one rightly beat up boiled egg.
That wasn't very nice, Mr. Breakstone.
Not Mr. Breakstone, just Breakstone, Breakstone, Breakstone.
Does this thing take coins?
It doesn't take coins.
Well, if it doesn't take coins, how does it work?
It don't work.
It don't work. It doesn't work.
Ain't worked in 15 years.
Well, how am I supposed to make a phone call?
A local call?
Yeah, I want to call the Begley Hotel.
Almost every place hereabouts is within shouting distance.
Shouting distance?
Yeah.
Well, which way would I shout?
West! What? Sit down there.
Yeah. Begley Hotel! Begley Hotel!
Beep! 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 That's the,
it's a busy signal.
Next time, when the man says,
the electric company gets its power from the Children's Television Workshop.
During the original run of the show, the full ending credits were only shown on Fridays.